first and foremost hallmark of a good content strategy is that it has to connect with the audience and engage with the audience in their local and native language. So I think the rise of Indic content consumption holds the key to a good marketing strategy within content. Now, within that itself, I think the form which there have been a lot of debate about what should the duration of content, especially in the video format or in the audio format. My point of view is that it's not the duration which matters in a good content strategy. It is the content engagement which matters, and there the best form, I believe, is storytelling. So I think if you can narrate strong, good, connected stories, it forms the backbone of a good content strategy, along with the regional and vernacular dimension to it. I don't think so. There's a direct correlation which you can put right now saying, okay, if I do content marketing, my overall marketing cost will go down. In initial stages, the way industry is right now, in fact, the cost could be even higher. Because, you know, what is going to happen is, like the way I talked some time back, is that content marketing is boundaryless. There are no political boundaries to it. You're consuming content in a certain language, sitting in completely different geography altogether. The life of content asset is much lower than the life of maybe a TV asset as we have known, right? So the assets get multiplied, the assets durations get shorter, and the assets timelines become shorter as well. So you will initially you'll have to maybe invest in multiple creatives. You'll have to find you going through multiple genres. You'll find yourself experimenting with multiple platforms. Hence, it's very difficult right now to say whether content marketing immediately can give you a cost saving on the overall marketing plan. What it can definitely do is it can give you much greater engaged quality if it is done rightly. And I think that's the perspective I would keep it and limit it to right now. And as I said, as scale and localization both take place, the cost will do come down. First of all, the biggest change and transition has been the awareness about digital evolution and digital adoption cannot happen without quality content, and more specifically regional quality content, because that's the way we are as a country. We are a country of multiple regions. So I think that's the first change which has happened in the last 4 to 5 years. That's a big realization. Second transition which is really happening is that we are clearly realizing that if this is the way, it's not a game of language, one language master to multiple language audits. It's a game of multiple language masters, and it's a game of faster, quicker turnarounds in content consumption. And I think that's putting a lot of pressure on the ecosystem. That's putting a lot of pressure on the marketing teams to keep pace. But I think that's also giving us a much better idea of how to connect and engage with digital audience. No, I don't agree with that, because the fact is, even though digital marketing spends are growing at the fastest rate among all constituents, the fact is TV itself is projected to grow at a healthier rate. Print strength has not gone down. So I guess there will be a space for at least these three medium, definitely I see, between TV, print and digital. Yes, digital will grow bigger, especially on the back of regional content. But I think traditional marketing will have its own evolution. We're already seeing TV, for example, is in any case moving on to digital screens. It's evolving in its own way. It's realizing that it needs to keep pace with this new technology updates. We've seen print gone online. So I think there will be a place for both traditional marketing and digital which will coexist. I don't think so there's any content marketing possible without evolution of technologies. I think the whole existence of digital today is the kind of technology disruptions we're seeing. Finally, the kind of technology disruptions which happen almost every quarter in the world today are changing the way our paradigms have always existed about marketing to consumers, even to digital consumers. And I think technology will keep on continuing challenging all of us and giving us some multiple and disruptive opportunities to reach out to audience in a very, very personalized way.